So, how do you warp text like this in Illustrator?
I'll show you the three steps to get it right and the three steps where often my students kind of get it wrong and get a little bit lost. It's all easy where you know where to look. Also have a class project at the end so that you can practice what you learned and share it with me.
And hang around to the end where I'll show you how to easily draw this flappy flaggy thing. I'm waving my hand like a flag. Not sure this helps in a voiceover. Anyway, warping type is good, but warping type in a flappy flag? Oh. All right, my name is Dan Scott. I'm an Adobe certified instructor. I teach design courses at byol.com. And today, me and you are gonna warp some text together. All right, step one. All right, to start, let's type some text and pick yourself a font.
I'm not exactly sure why it's fun to poke fun at BrushGrip, but it is fun.
All right, now select the text with the black arrow, the selection tool, and go up to Object, go down to Envelope Distort, and choose this one, Make with Warp. Or use the terrible shortcut, all the keys plus W. I'm pretty sure if you laid your face down on your keyboard, you'd probably hit the shortcut. Not useful. Anyway, there you go. We have warpy text. Now, each style in the dropdown can be adjusted by dragging these sliders here. There are lots of different options, and I'll let you experiment with them. But the two I use the most are flag, this one here, love a good flag, and arc, not arch, similar. Just don't like the way arch kind of deals and distorts this text here. But there's always a time and a place, except for fish. I love fish. It's always fun to play with, but I have never ever found a time and a place to use it. Sorry, fish warp. All right, step number two, we're gonna edit the shape now that it's made. Once you've clicked OK, getting back into that option, you select it once, and then normally over here in your quick actions, okay, in your properties panel, okay, you can go to warp options, and that should open up again. But sometimes, like here, it doesn't actually appear. And this brings me to the first of three places my students commonly get lost with warp text. What do you do now? One of two things, with it selected, you can go up to here, okay, and you can switch from edit the contents to edit the envelope. And look, it appears back. Or go the long way under Object and where we started, Envelope Distort. Can you see it? It says Edit Envelope. And then you can click your warp options, or of course you can lay your face down on the left side of your keyboard. That keyboard shortcut still works. All the buttons plus W. Or the really long way, go up to Object, Envelope Distort. And it's in here, and now it's called Reset with Warp. Either way, we can now edit it again. Yay! Disaster averted. And lastly, step three, how do you edit your text inside the shape? So sometimes you can grab your type tool and kind of like smash away and sometimes get it and sometimes not. Often you just get a new text box. It's not what I want. So this is the second place students get lost. Way to get around it is to select it once, go up here and make sure you're on Edit Contents and go to Outline Mode. Okay, which is Command Y on a Mac, Control Y on a PC. And it's just easier to work in this kind of like X-ray mode and change your text in here. You finish, hit Escape. Double click on the background and then hit Command or Control Y again. And we're back. Now, if you want a list of the good useful shortcuts in Illustrator like I'm using here, I've got this free printable shortcut sheet. You can download it. I'll leave a link in the description. All right, it is bonus time. It's the flappy flaggy bit. I can't stop. But before then, congratulations. You warped type in Illustrator. Hooray for us. We haven't gone into like extreme detail. If you do want to go into a bit more detail with warping type in Illustrator, I've got two videos in my paid Illustrator Essentials course. But for you, what I'll do is I'll make those particular two videos free, okay? And I'll put a link to those in the description if you want to get a bit nerdier with me. Or better yet, come join me for the full Illustrator Essentials course. We make all sorts of cool stuff like you see here on the screen. There'll be a link to that in the description as well. All right, bonus time. Let's make this flag. Are you doing the flaggy thing with your hand? Just me? Anyway, flags are cool and they appear in all sorts of, mainly like these old style kind of badge style graphics, but let me show you how to make an easy one like this. All right, drawing the flag brings me to the third and last place people get stuck kind of drawing bendy flaggy stuff. And it's this, we've got a bit of bendy text and we want to put the flag around it. It's tricky to do this way. I'll show you, I'm gonna go into it by double clicking it. I'm gonna grab my rectangle tool. I'm gonna try and draw around it. Oh man, it is really hard to add to something once it's in a bend. My advice, escape, 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 undo, undo, undo. So forget about that one. You stay over there. I'm gonna grab a new bit of type, make it nice and big, pick a font. We're gonna just draw our rectangle around this and then bend it all at the end. It's way easier. So
I'm going to use my rectangle tool, okay, and I'm going to click hold and drag a box around it. I'm going to pick a fill color and a stroke. I'm going to pick a nice beefy stroke. And the one thing that will make this easier for everybody, if you click on the word stroke here and you set your where the stroke is aligned, okay, aligning it to the inside makes it easier when you're trying to line up the extra flag details later on. That's a handy tip. All right, next, select it with the black arrow and send it to the back. That's Command Shift first square bracket or Control Shift first square bracket on a PC. Don't forget the shortcut sheet. What I'm gonna do is I'm gonna get it the right size-ish. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to duplicate this white box here. Okay, I'm using Option Drag on a Mac, Alt Drag on a PC to duplicate. It's going to shrink it down, and this is going to be my little flaggy part. Okay, it matches the right size. Just need the little pointy tong to do that. I'm going to hit the P key on my keyboard for the pen tool and just kind of click once in here. See the little plus? Now I'm going to grab my Direct Selection tool. That's the white arrow or the A key. I'm going to click it once. And just hit my left arrow. Just gonna kind of click and hold and drag. Hold shift and drag. It goes in bigger chunks. There you go, you can pick your desired pointiness. All right, I'm just gonna move mine to kind of get it to look like where it should go, somewhere like that. Send it to the back again, Command Shift and square bracket for a Mac, Control Shift square bracket on a PC, and it's at the back. All right, now we need a little triangle in there. I'm gonna zoom in, back to my pen tool. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to click on each of the corners, and you'll notice that it's actually easy now to click on the corners because we set the stroke to the inside. And hopefully if you've got your smart guides on, it should snap to all the points. It's a bit weird with the stroke kind of overlapping, but we can fix that by going to stroke, and just like before, let's go to align on the inside. You can leave yours like that. I want mine to have a nice black fill. There you go, we're getting close. Now let's duplicate it for the other side. So I'm going to shift click both of them. Gonna make a copy, okay, and I'm gonna flip it, and I'm gonna use this flip option here that I only just discovered. Is anybody else like me? You spent forever going to Object, Transform, Reflect, and then you forget preview's not turned on, and you're not sure if it's horizontal or vertical. Let me know in the comments if that's you, or if it's just me. Anyway, there's a handy button now in the Properties panel, Dan. All right, now we're gonna try and line it up over here. We're gonna use our X-ray mode again. We're gonna go Command Y. Control Y on a PC, and it just makes it a little easier to get everything to snap together. Command Y again, Control Y. We're gonna use our sweet shortcut to send to the back. Okay, and there we go. We've got a flag. Look at us. Now, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna group it, and I'm gonna make a couple of copies. First of all, you're way too big. And we're gonna do exactly like we did with the type. So I'm gonna start with this one and go up to Object, Envelope Distort, okay, Make with Warp. And then we're gonna go, hooray for Arc. It's going to work my way through a few options. There you go. We've got flags and text and a cool little warp. Love it. Now, if you are looking for a little bit of practice, not homework, I want you to create your own warped text and stick it into a flag. You get bonus points if you add lots of little triangles. Now, I don't mind what you make. Remember, it's not a beauty pageant. It is just some practice. So make something and share it with me at one of the social media spots. When you do, just make sure you use the hashtag BYOLWARP. And if you search for that term, you'll be able to see what other people have made as well. All right, my friend, that is it. Thanks for hanging out. That is warping text in Illustrator. If you maybe want to go further, remember, check out my Illustrator Essentials course, Illustrator Advanced. I'm pointing down because the link is in the description. But if you had fun and you want to carry on, you might check out this video here. Okay, this one here is Illustrator Type on a Path, similar to warping text, okay, but better for badges and that type of thing. That might be a next step. But that's it. Hide it out, people. Bye.